Good morning, all of you. Myself Pooran, Department of Mechanical Engineering in Arya College of Engineering and IT. Today's topic is measurement of flow. So basically, the flow measurement is the process of measuring the fluid in a plant or industry. There are some flow measurement instruments are used like flow meter, water flow meter or magnetic flow meter. In generally, the flow is measured in two ways, volumetric basis and other is weight basis. The flow of solid are usually measured in terms of mass per unit time or weight per unit time. Liquid flow is measured volumetrically or in the basis of weight, and the gaseous flow is normally measured only volumetrically. Now we discuss about the rotameter. So a rotameter is a device that measures the volumetric flow rate of the fluid in a closed tubes. Two pressure measurement with rotameters. The rotameter is an industrial flow meter used to measure the flow rate of liquids and gas, and the rotameter consists of a tubes and float. The float reposes the flow rate chain is linear, and a 10 to 1 flow range or a turn down is standard. Now we discuss about the basic construction of rotameter. So in figures, the main components of rotameter: first is scale, second clear or a tapered glass tube or plumet or a float stove. There are basic two part, one is inlet part or other is outlet part. Inlet part a small size, and outlet compared to some big size. So a rotameter is made up of a tapered tube and a float inside it. The glass tapered tube has a scale on the surface, or a scale is placed adjust into it according to the application or a purpose. So the rotameter have main two components. One is tapered tubes and other is float. The taper tube is placed vertical in the flow channel with a conical shape inside. The quantity measured is defined by the height of fluid float going up. The glass tube are used for both liquid and gas measurements. Metallic tubes are used where the process fluid is high temperature and pressure. Float, stainless steel float are commonly used in a rotameter, but there are different types of metals from lead to aluminium are also used as a float. The float material shape are also varied according to the application, considering density, and the spherical shape float are used for small flow. So the basic working principle or a working of rotameter. In a rotameter, fluid enter from the bottom of the taper tube, then some of the fluid strike directly into the float bottom section, and other or some fluid pass aside the float. Now the float experience two forces are generated in the taper section, that is called taper tube. One is drag force and other is gravitational force. So in opposite direction, the drag force upward direction and gravitational force are acting in downward direction. Fluid flow move the float upward against the gravity. At some points, the flowing area reach at a point where the pressure induced force on the floating body exactly matches and the weight of the fluid, weight of the float. The float will find equilibrium when the area around the float generate enough drag equal to the weight. That is called buoyancy. As the float weight and gravity are constant, the distance float displaced upward is proportional to the flow velocity of the fluid passing through the tapered tubes. Some advantage of rotameters. No external power needed in a rotameter. Simple, reliable in design, can measure liquid or a gas. Both scale is approximately linearly are used. It can measure flow rate of corrosive fluids, better rangeability and low cost and low pressure drops in a rotameter. Some disadvantage are occurs in a rotameter. It should be mounted vertically only. So the limitation of rotameter and other is, and the required lining mounting and uncertainty of measurements. This is the biggest disadvantage of rotameter. Difficult to handle the glass tube. So there are the different disadvantages occur in a rotometers. Thanks. Any query? Okay.